At this very moment, your gut is filled with almost 100 trillion microbes, most of which are bacteria of 300 to 500 different types. However, there are also fungi, protists, and viruses in there too. To put it in perspective, that means there are more than 12,000 times as many microorganisms in your body as there are human beings on the planet. In fact, there is about one bacteria for every human cell. Now, did you ever imagine such a huge population of tiny creatures living inside you? But why do we have so many microbes inside us? Where do they come from, and what do they do? We've only recently begun to understand their complex role in our bodies, and as it turns out, they are far more important than we ever imagined. The microbial journey all begins in the uterus. The amniotic fluid in a mother's uterus contains bacteria, so when the fetus swallows some of that fluid, the microbes take a seat in the fetus's gut. However, it is only after birth that the microbes begin their colonization of the body. During the birth, the bacteria present in the mother's vagina cover the baby and find their way to the gut as the baby emerges. This is why babies born through a C-section procedure have a different gut microbiota composition as compared to their natural birth counterparts. The bacteria in the gut consists of a few different types of characters. Some are neutral, just minding their own business in the gut, while others are part of a mutually beneficial relationship with our cells. Some, more worryingly, can cause diseases like cholera, or just give you cavities or bad breath. So how does a newborn deal with all of these disease-causing bacteria? Breast milk. Breast milk contains antibodies that protect newborn babies until their immune systems learn to fight for itself. Breast milk also contains human milk oligosaccharides. These are sugar molecules that boost good bacterial growth. It's a natural prebiotic that helps increase the population of bifidobacterium, an important type of bacteria that is present in a baby's gut. Antibodies, along with the good bacteria, prevent the nasty bacteria from finding a permanent home in the baby's gut. As the tiny human grows up, their body changes, as does their food intake, bringing a whole new flavor to the gut microbes party. New foods introduce new microbial residents in the gut, which can then mingle with older residents. The new foods also bring new nutrients that support the growth of diverse gut bacteria. After about 3 years of age, the gut and its microbes resemble those of an adult. They are found throughout the gut, although their numbers are highest in the large intestine, especially the colon. So, we know how they get in, but what are they doing there? And more importantly, why does everyone keep saying they're good? Well, these residents interact with our bodies in many ways, but most importantly, they affect our digestion. On average, 60 tons of food passes through your GI tract over the course of your life. That amounts to eating 10 elephants or a fully fueled airplane. Our bodies don't have the right enzymes to break down complex sugars like starch and other polysaccharides, but gut bacteria do. Their enzymes break down these sugars to make B-group vitamins and vitamin K. The gut bacteria release this into the intestine, where it is absorbed by our own cells. We should thank our gut bacteria, as we need these vitamins for our body to stay healthy. Second, the gut microbes affect our brain. Essentially, the gut microbes have our brain on speed dial, and they help coordinate our body's functions. This system is known as the gut-brain axis. The two-way communication between our central nervous system and enteric nervous system, the nervous system linked to the gut, allows our gastrointestinal tract and brain to talk to each other. This back-and-forth conversation helps our body maintain physiological balance, also known as homeostasis. The gut microbes even release certain molecules and hormones that can affect our brain. Gut bacteria like Corynebacterium feed on the food we eat and produce metabolites like serotonin. This serotonin is released into our blood, where eventually it interacts with our nervous system. This then signals the brain, thus affecting our moods and emotions. Some other metabolites include GABA, a neurotransmitter, and butyrate, which interacts in other critical ways with the nervous system. Depending on how healthy our gut bacteria are, our brain signaling can be affected, which could impact our hormonal responses. This is why when you have indigestion or stomach problems, you may feel an unusual level of anxiety or irritability. To learn even more about the parts of the brain involved in emotions, check out our video on the limbic system. Your gut bacteria can also help put you to bed. Certain gut bacteria release sleep-inducing compounds called miramil peptides. People with an unhealthy gut bacteria profile tend to have poor sleep patterns. Your immune system also has your gut microbes to thank for their success. Gut bacteria and the immune system collaborate to keep disease-causing bacteria at bay. The immune system matures and learns from the gut bacteria that are present, while the gut bacteria secrete certain metabolites that further help your defenses. But how do gut bacteria perform such helpful tasks? What gives them so much power? These bacteria have the genes to produce metabolites that affect our physiology. All these genes in the gut bacteria make up what we know as the gut microbiome. Interestingly, more than 99% of the genes in our body are microbial. But how can we increase our good gut bacteria strength? Disease, genetics, or lifestyle, such as eating too much junk food, can mess with our microbial residence, causing dysbiosis. Dysbiosis is a major imbalance of the types of gut bacteria in the body, but it can be remedied. The best thing to do is try your best to live a healthy, conventional lifestyle. A consistent sleep schedule, regular exercise, a balanced diet, and keeping stress levels to a minimum will do wonders. There are also probiotics and prebiotics that can help keep your gut balanced. Probiotics are good bacteria that we put in our bodies in high enough numbers to actually have a beneficial effect. These bacteria can be consumed by taking capsules or eating probiotic foods, such as cheese, yogurt, and other bacteria-rich dishes. Prebiotics are foods with molecules like inulin, fructooligosaccharides, or galactooligosaccharides, which allow good gut bacteria to grow even better. Consult your doctor to find out what approach is right for you. So, the next time you're procrastinating on going to the gym or being tempted towards eating that greasy pizza, consider the consequences it will likely have on the fascinating and impactful ecosystem in your gut.